Of how when you're done with your talk, make sure to hit the right arrow until you're at the yellow slide. Yeah, there we go. So next up, we have Jake Alperin-Sheriff, who's going to tell us a NIST update.
Hi. We just had our first PQ+1 standardization workshop for Lauderdale. Almost everyone comes into this scheme. They were able to finish on time with 15 minutes. Maybe everyone here can learn something from that. But anyway, thank you all for making it a success. So moving forward in our post-box standardization, we started out with about 84 submissions at the beginning. Thanks to some work on my part, I thought that 69 would be a very nice number of submissions. We ended up with 69 complete proper ones. Of those, 5 are withdrawn, and then there are about 54 that don't have any serious attacks as far as we know. Of those, then we then have to get down. I was going to make a chai joke and put 18 here, but my team said, no, you can't put a number there. They'll hold us to it. So no concrete goal yet for the second round, but we do need to narrow it. And we expect to have our decisions by early 2019. So I want to say a little bit about the breaks by problem category, because it can say one of two things. So as you can see, the categories of variants of LWE are untrue, quasi-signaling carrier check codes, GOP codes, isotomy, and for signatures, LWE, multivariate, symmetric crypto has not really had any attacks, whereas the other stuff, basically the only thing left is Dan Bernstein's post-quantum RSA, which so this can mean one of two things. This can mean either, you know, when we see a cryptanalysis, when someone has cryptanalysis and they have success, they'll let you know about it. They'll publish it, they'll post it on ePrint. But when someone tries to cryptanalyze something and they fail, dead silence. We have no idea whether anyone has looked at it. We'd really like to hear both. If you're too ashamed to tell us that you looked at something and failed, make up a burner email and send it to us. We really want to hear, because we can't make it. It's much easier to make a decision if we know we have some estimate of how many break cycles we wanted to try to break these things versus maybe nobody's looked at it. So beyond post-quantum, which is what I work on, we also have a lightweight crypto standardization initiative about to start. We just came out with a draft call for submissions. So send your comments to lightweight-crypto@nist.gov. Tell us what we did wrong in the draft call, and we'll try to fix it up and finalize it based on your comments. Wow, it looks like I took too much time. No, I have one more slide. Finally, we have the NIST randomness beacon, which I guess has been around for a while. It's at 512 random bits per minute, timestamp, sign, hash chain, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. But we recognize that some people may not trust the US government entirely. So our new version of that is coming out. We don't know why no one wouldn't trust the US government, but we have a feeling that some people might not. Anyway, we have a new randomness field that allows us to combine beacons with other countries, and it'll be interoperable with beacons in Brazil, Chile, and some other countries. I guess these are some of the envisioned applications, randomization, various things, and we'd appreciate hearing your suggestions. I guess you should probably, John Kelsey didn't put his email, if you don't know it, it's john.kelsey@nist.gov, or you can probably talk to him in crypto, or if you don't want to talk to him, via email. All right, thank you very much.